To bring the word of the Lord and the power of his judgment.
Amen.
Oh,
amen.
I am the Reverend Nolan Bliss, and I come to New Hope Valley.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. We were expecting to get tomorrow.
Well, I was come a day early for thinking and praying and fasting.
Well, we're glad to have you, brother, and you've come in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
This is Brother Hayes, Brother Leaf, and Brother Ott. We're the elders of this church.
You're welcome among us.
We pray
to bless us.
We're praying for a harvest of souls.
Amen. And I'm proud to be in your midst, my friends. So let's pray that the lost shall be found.
Amen.
To be washed in the blood that cleanses the stream. Oh, let's pray that the lost shall be found.
Amen.
Resume your stepping under the eye of the Lord, and let me nothing that passed between you, but you wouldn't want him to see.
Amen. Amen.
For the Lord seeth all.
Amen.
Amen. Now he do.
That's getting all the boys.
Susannah, folks, was raised by her brother that don't draw soul the breath. He's a trifling one that Sam is. Sam Hope is the name he was given. He just hunts and traps and fishes all day. He's always drunk at night.
Let's pray for his soul and his sisters. I'll pray for them both tonight.
They're poor as shitless and do. Better dead to them, that's all.
Susannah and Sam is here. There's bad blood in that family. It's too pretty a face, and wickedness. She'll come to no good, mark my words. She'll come to no good, mark my words.
I'll pray for them both tonight. I'll join the young folks in dancing quite a spell.
There is peace on your shore.
Amen, preacher.
Same.
My folks don't like me coming here. They're scared of what Sam might do. My ma says there's bad blood in your family. Awful pretty tonight, Susannah. You were pretty at the square dance tonight. All them men was sure courting you. I see them, everyone.
Oh, well, nothing of the kind. You're storying again, that's what.
The preacher, he come to your square. I see him use a mat, pleased, I'd say.
He seems like a real nice fella, though he ain't much intent for true. He stepped on my feet so much on the top.
Ain't it a pity?
Appalachia.
Curse not, Sam. I am only for that yet.
Sure you're the robin. You're going on 19. Pretty soon you'll be an old maid. Party, wench, and I'm proud to have you here, and I'm real proud to eat your cooking.
Don't go to bed by the eight sail. Sing me the jaybird song first. Remember how Paul used to always sing the jaybird before it comes again. You have sung it for me in a long time now, and it always makes me feel real happy.
All right, I'll sing you the jaybird. Then we gotta get to bed. Sitting on a hickory limb, he went to me and I went to him. I picked up a brickbat and hit him on the chin. Look ahead, little boy, don't you do that again. Oh, Jaybird sitting on a hickory limb, he went to me and I went to him. I picked up a brickbat, hit him on the chin. Look ahead, little boy, don't you do that again. Oh, hey. Jaybird, give back my head! Jaybird, give me back my
right about here.
I haven't seen it for some years now.
I recollect it was on the old pond place.
It may be dried up by now, like the one we use for baptism this summer.
We gotta find it. Brother Bitch will be needing a baptism creek by sundown come tomorrow. I mark him as a man to bring in sinners, and there's gotta be a creek already. It'll be summers around here.
It's an outrage. It's a blasphemous outrage.
I'm bathing in a public place.
Naked as for her bed was born.
It's a shameful sight to behold.
She's a shameless wench. This Susannah is my wife. Others said she was evil, and she was right. My brethren, she was mighty right. This girl, she belongs to the devil.
Exposing herself in plain view for all who care to see.
The church won't stand for a thing like this. The people, they must be told.
She must be brought to revenge.
Yes, Brother Blake,
she must be told.
This woman is of the devil. She without a saving grace. She must be brought to repentance before she meets God face to face.
At Brother McLean's house now, a praying that if so I be saved, that I shall turn aside from her evil ways and be washed in the cleansing stream.
She's a powerful one, the Susannah Pope. My son she lured away from all the things that he'd been teach. For that she's gonna have to pay.
That's right. Zip.
Sam here.
He's inside asleep.
I had to come tell you, Susannah.
Tell me what?
I just had to come tell you.
Tell me what? Oh, you was there tonight. What is it, little man? What have I done?
My pa and the other elders, they seen you bathing this morning. Bathing without a stitch on, exposing yourself without no shame. They're gonna get you for doing that. They say it were a scandalous thing, and they're gonna run you out in the church, and maybe the valley too. They say that
I've been bathing there all spring.
They was looking for a baptism creek, and they found that only you was in it. A bathing naked as a jaybird, they say it were a shameful sight.
I've been bathing there.
And he's prayed for your soul all day. They told all the church folks, I reckon, and the whole valley knows, so they say.
Why, little man, why? I ain't got nothing, I ain't.
They say there ain't a feller in these parts but safe with you around. They say you let them love you while they want, and then send their souls to hell. They say you've got the devil in you. They say they've known it for a long time now. They say that you're an evil gal. You are, and that you're bound to get your due.
Thank you.
is more what you don't know.
Thank you. what you mean by take, little sparrow? You know what he's waiting for. He's waiting for public confession.
But there ain't nothing for me to confess, Sam. There ain't nothing for me to confess. I've prayed and prayed to see the light. If something I've done's been wrong, but I still don't feel.
It must be a powerful one. I ain't never seen so many people getting baptized.
It's good.
course not, little Robin. Of course not.
Will you come back as soon as you can? As soon as you empty the drops?
Sure I will. And don't you fret. I'll be back before you miss me. I'll be back with a sack full of critters. And we'll have food for all next week. Now will you go to the meeting tonight?
Please don't ask me to do that, Sam. I can't, I just can't.
You gotta show me you ain't afraid. And no harm would come to you there. And I'd feel a whole lot better to know you was there instead of here. Just go for a little while this evening, and I'll be back tomorrow by sundown.
I can't wait till things look pretty again.
Preach no regular sermon.
Why not?
The Lord
He spoke to me this afternoon.
What did he say?
He said, Rich, there's gonna be a lot of lost souls at that meeting tonight.
Mercy!
Don't take no text. I'll put the words in your mouth.
Amen.
This week's drawn to a close, and there's some still to be brought to salvation. So close your Bible and speak through me.
Amen.
So the Lord, he spoke to me this afternoon, and that's what I aim to do.
Amen.
I want to see the biggest baptism yet tomorrow evening when we gather at the usual place at sundown.
And yes. It will.
Grant it, Lord. Grant it, Lord. Grant it, Lord.
I'm fixin' to tell you about a feller I knowed, but was young and smart and rich. Except he never put much thought on his poor lost soul. Oh, where he'd spend eternity. One night when I was preaching in Texas, I was called to his home that night. And there he lay sweating, with his eyes all staring with fright.
He
grabbed me by the hand and said, tell me I'm a dying man, and I might not get through the night. Seems like my poor heart's gonna run down soon, and I wanna make everything right. I ain't lived such a bad life. I ain't drank nor smoked nor swore, but I'm all afeard of dying. I'm sure there's something more. Shaved! That was it. And he died that night. Well, I'm scared to death, and his soul went to eternal fire. And there's many of you this very night, which in the same fix as this poor man. Where will your soul be tonight if you were suddenly took away? Where will you spend eternity with the saved of the Lord? What's around his throne? Or down below with a squealing and wailing and gnashing of a teeth? Down in the bottomless pit, where they holler for water, they ease parched tongues, but they ain't none to be heard. Is that where you'd be? Brethren, you better think on it. There ain't a one of us what couldn't be took at any time. Not one of us, and I'm including myself. Are you prepared? When they open them judgment books up there, which side of the page will you be on? Tonight ain't too soon. Tomorrow might be too late. Tomorrow might be too late. So while the congregation sings a hymn, I want to see all those whose souls want saving and wants to become free of the heavy burden of sin.
Yes, Lord.
Come down and meet the Lord now, here at the altar.
Come, sinner, tonight's the night to take us.
ask the Lord for forgiveness. But you won't never be sorry for humbling yourself in this way. Tonight it pays no mind to the wooing the God in her heart. I've wrestled for her soul with the devil and prayed and put a stem in the fix of the Lamb and put aside her sinful and shameful words. And still she don't heed my pleading. Give over, sister.
Yes, amen.
While the congregation sings one more verse, publicly confess your sins and ask forgiveness of the Lord and these good folks present here tonight.
Yes, sister.
Amen.
Tell you first, and I saw the night.
Sing so pretty.
Soul, not after night, may
maybe tomorrow you'll come to the light.
Like a morning glory when the sun comes.
hearken to my plea for forgiveness.
Receive my confession, O Lord, and hear the words of my repentance. It's a horrible thing I have done. Forgive the weakness of my flesh, O Lord, and condemn me not to the eternal fire for my sin against thee and the world. She was untouched, O Lord. She was untouched before her young body was defiled by my hands. Defiled by my lust. Forgive. And grant my tortured soul the balm of thy forgiveness. What shall I do if thou desert me? Leave me not in this way, no sin oppressing me. And condemn me not to the fires of hell. Return. Sistren, I ask you to come here this morning for the purpose of righting a terrible wrong.
Amen.
It's a blessed privilege for our Lord to let us make restitution for our errors while we are alive.
That's right.
Amen. We've all been error, brethren and sistren. Bad error. Who sits over there has been a victim of our error.
She
is innocent of the charges against her and the grievous of the things she's adored. I ask you to receive her forgiveness and humbly ask her pardon for your discouragement.
I'm sorry, I preach it.
How do you know she's innocent, creature?
The Lord spoke to me in the night when I was praying for her soul. I swear to thee, she's innocent. She's innocent of the charges you made. Make restitution now, brethren.
We'll see you at the baptism, preacher.
Amen.
The trad, Susannah. You heard me.
Yeah, I heard you.
I'll make it up to you. I swear I will.
How?
Susannah, please try and forgive me.
Forgive? I forgot what that word means.
Thank you.
And nobody seed him, but we all seed him when he run away. And the preacher sank right down in the creek with a pool of blood around him. And before they could drag him out, he was dead. And he was praying real hard before he died, asking forgiveness for his sins, and asking the Lord to bless you. It was a terrible thing to hear. And the folks is coming here to get you. They say you put Sam up to it, and they say they're gonna run you out in the valley and hang Sam too if they catch him. They're a-coming, Susannah, don't you hear him? What you gonna do, Susannah? What you gonna do? You better run, Susannah. They're getting close, they're getting close. You better run, Susannah. You better run!
Thank you. Thank you.